I decided to try out the Creation Club beta patch and the new survival mode whilst it is currently free and see what issues would await us once it arrived vis-a-vis SkyUI and Immersive HUD. How compatible were they going to be with both the patch itself and the survival mode? As you can see, when you first sign up for the survival mode and load in game, you will get an option to enable it. If you do enable it, you'll probably be told you're carrying too much because, let's face it, we all are. Now, the only thing that I want to show you right now is the settings menu. And that's because I don't have SkyUI or Immersive HUD installed. If I go on to gameplay, I now have an option for survival mode. I can turn it on and I can turn it off. And I still have the difficulty. This is now like independent of survival mode. Whereas those of you who remember it in Fallout 4 will remember the survival mode was actually a difficulty level that was added to the end. I actually prefer this way of doing it, I have to say. Survival mode should not have been linked to difficulty. Some people are going to want to play on easy difficulty for combat difficulty, but still have the survival mode feature. So, you know, this is actually how I would have done this. This is how I wish they'd done it for Fallout 4. I'm just showing you this so we've got a point of reference, something to compare. Now I've run the game with survival mode and SkyUI and Immersive HUD installed. Don't worry, I did all of my testing with both mods separately, so I do know which mod is affected by the survival mode in which way. I have isolated it, but I'm going to show you both of them at the same time. For SkyUI, most of the functionality seems to be working just fine. However, if I go to the settings menu, you will see immediately the survival mode is missing. I still have the difficulty, but I cannot set survival mode to on or off. Well, I can if I first choose it when I load the game, but I cannot turn it off after that. And if I don't choose yes when I load the game, I cannot turn it on either. The problem with the difficulty slider is I can change the difficulty. And if I exit the menu and then go back, it's actually reset to novice. This doesn't seem to matter what difficulty I choose. When I go back, it will have changed to novice. Now, this doesn't occur if I exit, it saves, but I don't leave the menu. If I go back in, go to settings, it will have remembered it. However, if I go out of the menu and right back in, there you go. Obviously, that is a fairly big problem. And if you're thinking, well, I'm not going to use survival mode, so it won't affect me, I'm afraid here it is without survival mode installed, but with the patch itself. And you can actually see you don't even get a difficulty slider if you do that. No survival mode, no difficulty slider whatsoever. Oh, and by the way, one totally odd thing. Apparently, once you've signed up for survival mode, the only way to disable it, to remove it from your game, is to actually delete the files. Maybe I'm being a little dense, but I don't see an option in the Creation Club part to disable it, as you can see. And would it come under home? No, that's featured. And with the add-ons, just gives me Dawnguard, Hearthfire, and Dragonborn, and mods is obviously only the things that classify as mods, which currently is SkyUI and iHUD. I do think they're going to need some sort of system like this where you can disable the ESL and not have survival mode. I mean, it's not the end of the world to delete the files from the data folder if you don't want to use them anymore, but that's a little messy. Now, for Immersive HUD, it seems to work pretty much out of the box. There is, of course, a new icon for overloaded, and now that I am overloaded, my stamina is dropping and it will be visible the entire time. You know what? Why am I worried about dropping? I'm actually trying to go off and drop stuff in a barrel so I don't lose it, even though I have absolutely no intention of saving this or carrying on. I'm insane. Yes, I am. Okay. That still feels wrong. So, immersive HUD, it seems to work just fine. The compass appears when I press X by default. MCM seems to work just fine for both immersive HUD and Sky UI. But there is one problem, and that problem is the active effects, and I have no idea why. I'm going to take the water breathing potion. You can see the active effect has appeared. It is not linked to the compass, and it does not seem to matter what I do. That active effect is always there. The reason that's strange is that active effect is added by Sky UI. Not 100% sure if that's an immersive HUD problem or a Sky UI problem with the Creation Club, to be honest. And I can't, there's no way of separating them because, of course, immersive HUD requires Sky UI to control the widgets anyway. Sorry, widgets are what we call things that appear on the heads-up display. So, okay, apparently I'm hungry. I do apologize. So, when I take a potion and it appears as an active effect, that is actually Sky UI. And at the moment, that is not under control. That is something I do need to fix, even if you don't want to use survival mode. This is the Creation Club patch without survival mode, and you will see straight away active effects are visible in spite of the fact that immersive HUD is installed. So it doesn't matter whether or not you want to try out survival mode, this will be a problem. So when the game updates, when the patch comes, active effects will start appearing, and I will need to look into immersive HUD to find out why that is happening. I'm not sure if it's a problem with immersive HUD or a problem with Sky UI. I can also tell you that immersive HUD does not hide any of the survival mode elements, like the overloaded icon you can see at the top now, although that does fade after a while. And if your stamina gets hurt by the fact that you're carrying too much or the fact that you're hungry, it will show up. So even if you're slightly hungry, the stamina bar is going to show up. I do not imagine I'm going to be adding any features specific to survival mode, because honestly, immersive HUD is only a PC mod. There's no way I can convert it for console anyway, and I see pretty much no reason anyone would use survival mode on PC. We have mods that do the same thing and more. They do it better, they're more polished, they have more features, and of course, they're free. So anybody who's thinking of using survival mode for PC, there really is no reason other than basically you don't want to install mods, and if that's the case, you don't want to install immersive HUD, Sky UI, and SKSE64. So I think it would be wasted work. Plus, to be honest with you, there's no way in hell I'm spending, was it 800 credits now? The price has gone up. There's no way I'm spending that amount of money on this mode, especially seeing as they've gone the whole microtransaction route of making you buy currency and pricing it in such a way that you actually have to spend, I think it's $15 for this mode. So, not doing that. Anyway, I did not want to complain about the Creation Club in this video. I've done that enough already, and I'm sure you guys are sick to death of hearing it. That's the situation. Once the Creation Club patch arrives, Sky UI will need a fix because of the settings menu issue, and immersive HUD might require some attention. I don't know for sure yet. I will check it out immediately and update you guys accordingly. And that is all I've got to say. So I hope this video was informative and helpful.